Hello, my name is Rane. I am a senior clinical application specialist with Philips Ultrasound. In this video, you will see a demonstration of Perkinab for prostate fusion. Prostate cancer is the fifth leading cause of death due to cancer in men. The traditional methods of ultrasound-guided prostate biopsies are not always reliable due to poor visualization of lesions and inaccurate sampling. Since prostate tumors are better detected on MR, fusion with real-time ultrasound can enable a more targeted approach to prostate biopsies. And this can help to improve the prostate cancer detection. The tools that are required to perform prostate fusion are C104EC transducer, tracking bracket, endocavity ultrasound tracker, patient tracker, and the electromagnetic field generator. Connect the field generator to the connection port on the rear side of the system. Align the red dot on the cable and the red dot on the connector. Also connect the tool connection unit to the system with the help of TCU cable. Plug in the patient tracker and the transducer tracker in the tool connection unit. Usually, the transrectal ultrasound is performed with patient lying in left lateral decubitus position. Place the patient tracker on the stable position like hip or thigh region. For this demo, I'm going to use this prostate phantom and I will place the patient tracker on the phantom. Load the MR dataset by either using CD, DVD, USB, or you can query retrieve it directly from PACS. We usually use actual MR data with T2 sequence, preferably with 2 mm slice thickness. Perkinab also supports non-axial datasets, that is coronal and sagittal planes. Select the C104 endocavity transducer and prostate preset. Place the transducer tracker on the transducer. Cover the transducer and the tracker with sterile cover. And then place the biopsy guide. Position the field generator to the appropriate position for the procedure. Select the MR data from review and then select fusion. There are five different registration methods. For prostate fusion, I am going to use internal plane match. With ultrasound, scan the prostate to locate image plane with internal landmark that can also be visualized on MR. For example, urethra. Click to place the crosshair on this landmark with left trackball set key. This will freeze the ultrasound image. Scroll through the MR images. Select the same landmark on MR by placing the crosshair with left trackball set key. The ultrasound and MR image is now overlaid on the left frame. Use the blend control to adjust the blend ratio to check the overlay match of images. You can also make minor adjustments with the transducer if needed. If you are satisfied with ultrasound plane registration, then touch Match Plane. Scan different planes to verify accuracy of the image fusion. Keep in mind that too much of transducer pressure can change the position and shape of the prostate. In case, if you want to make fine adjustment to the fusion, then you can use the following controls, that is point-to-point, transducer, or trackball. You can set the target in MR image where the suspected lesion is most probably seen. Once you set the target, the ultrasound guidance bar will appear on the screen. If the guidance bar is yellow or blue, that indicates target is out of scan plane. No bar indicates that the ultrasound image and the target are in the same plane. Activate the biopsy line by going to 2D tab. Align the target with the biopsy line and get the targeted biopsy sample of the lesion. One thing to keep in mind is you may have to turn the transducer left or right for better biopsy access while maintaining the same transducer pressure. So, to conclude, MR ultrasound fusion is designed to improve the effectiveness of prostate biopsy by providing a targeted biopsy approach. And this can help to improve prostate cancer detection. Thank you for watching this video.